हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सुषमा तोमर, गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट प्रैक्टिसिंग एट कल्याण उल्लासनगर. आई एम कंसल्टेंट एट फोर्टिस हॉस्पिटल कल्याण एंड आई एम डायरेक्टर ऑफ तोमर नर्सिंग होम, आईवीएफ सेंटर एंड एंडोस्कोपी सेंटर. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वाज व्हाट आर द कॉजेज फॉर द इरेगुलर मेंसेस एंड हाउ टू मैनेज इट. सो फर्स्ट वी शुड नो व्हाट इज द नॉर्मल साइकिल. What is the normal period? That's very important to know all the youth, Rotaract and everybody. So any menstrual cycle is start at the age of 10 to 15 years is normal. If it is delayed, then we have to work out if you are not getting your period after 15 years of age. Second thing, if cycle is from 25 days to 35 days, it's absolutely normal. Nothing wrong over there. If you are having bleeding from 3 to 5 days, per month is absolutely normal, and amount of bleeding you should know, 3 to 4 napkin per day is normal. If it is going to be more, if it is going to be less, means something is wrong. So once you are knowing your normal menstrual cycle, then we can think of what's abnormal menstrual cycle and how to manage it. So once we are talking about the irregular menstrual cycle, we have to know the age of patient, number one, and then we have to find out the cause why she is getting the irregular menses. So once we are talking irregular menses, means whether it is early before 25 days or it is late after 35 days. So whether you are getting period in every 10-15 days, that's irregular cycle. If you are getting period every 40 days, 50 days, 60 days late, then it is irregular cycle. Or amount of bleeding is different, what I said, from 3 to 5 days, then we have to think of whether bleeding is heavy or it is less. So there are different causes for the irregular menses. Like first important thing in the adolescent, it's a hormonal deficiency, because hormones, it takes time up to 18 year of age. Sometime it is late because it takes time to develop to normal uterus and hormonal level. So if it is coming little late, we have not to bother much. We have to just supplement with the vitamins. If it is coming very early, then definitely we have to work out ki why she is getting early. Irregular period, we have to diagnose according to history whether she is having from the starting irregular period is there, or whether it was normal before, now it is coming late. One thing. Second thing, what's the, whether she is married, she is unmarried, and whether she is having issue, children are there or no, whether she was pregnant using any contraceptive. So many detailed history we have to, we should know to find out what's the cause for the menstrual irregularity. So most common causes are the hormonal imbalance. Hormones, like we should know, for maintaining our menstrual cycle, we are secreting some of the hormones from the pituitary gland or our brain, hypothalamus. So that maintain our cycle. So these hormones are estrogen hormone, progesterone hormone, prolactin hormone, and thyroid hormones. So about these, we should have the one small general knowledge. So any of the hormone is having disturbance, whether it's a estrogen or progesterone or thyroid or prolactin, then there is a disturbance in the period cycle. So whenever we think of ki we have to diagnose the patient ki why she is getting the irregular period, then we should do the hormones test on second or third day of the period. So we can find out the, what are the baseline hormones, and baseline, according to baseline hormone, we have to give the supplement if she is having irregular period. Second important thing is just to see the anatomy of uterus. So at the time of period, we should do the pelvic sonography. So we can find out in the sonography whether uterus is normal, whether uterus is having some infection, whether uterus is having some fibroid, some tumor, or some ovarian tumor is there. So anything having inside the uterus or ovary that can cause the irregular period, or any hormonal change from the pituitary gland to hypothalamus, that can again cause the irregular period. So line of treatment depend. First we have to diagnose according to age, according to marital level, according to how many children she is having, and then line of treatment depend on that only. If she is having hormonal imbalance, then we have to give 3 to 6 month hormones. if she is having fibroid uterus, then depend on the size and location of the fibroid, then we have to treat either medical treatment or the surgical treatment. If she is having some ovarian cyst, ovarian tumor, then accordingly what type of tumor it is, that we have to give the either medical treatment or the surgical treatment. So treatment part depend according to the cause of irregular period. So we should know ki what's the normal cycle and what's the cause for the irregular period, and then depend the whether it's a medical line of treatment or the surgical line of treatment. Thank you.